Good afternoon, children.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Had your lunch? Ma'am. You had your lunch?
No, ma'am.
No. Why so late? No, it's 1:50, no?
Ma'am, two classes. Yes.
You had lunch break from 12 to 12:30. Yes. 12 to 12:30, you were free, no? You didn't feel like having. Tell me that. Okay, lunch break is there, 12 to 12:30, just like you have it in the school. Okay, children, so we were learning about food preservation in our previous class. We learned about some of the common methods of preserving food. Can anybody tell me those, list out those different methods? Hesa, can you?
Yes, ma'am. Food is spoiled by microorganisms.
No, Hesa, you don't have to explain it. Just the headings, the different techniques for preserving. One method I will say, chemical method. Second one? Preservation by? Gauri?
Bacteria.
Preservation by salt.
Sugar. Preservation by salt. Third method?
Sugar.
Preservation by sugar. Then?
By oil and vinegar.
Preservation by oil and vinegar. Then?
Then heat and cold
treatment. Heat and cold treatment. So five methods we had already learned. Hesa is going to repeat all those once again.
Yes, ma'am. Sugar.
Don't simply say sugar. Preservation using sugar. Then?
Vinegar.
Preservation by, you say it in a, simply if you say it will be the name of some products that you in your kitchen. So say it in a proper sentence. Preservation by?
Vinegar.
Vinegar and oil. Then? Preservation by?
Salt.
Two methods you said. Preservation by salt. Preservation by using vinegar and oil. Then? Three more methods. Preservation by sugar. Chemical method. And the last method? Dash and dash treatment. You didn't revise last day's portion. Johane, which one she missed out? Which one she missed out? Once again? Five methods we learned. Four she said. One she has missed out. Which one she missed out? Who can say? Yes, Isa.
Heat and cold.
Heat and cold treatment. Children, please do revise your previous day's portion so that we can save everyone's time. And when one is answering in the class, that time also you have to be very attentive. Otherwise, what happens is from the 40 or 45 minutes what we have, time will just get wasted. Okay? And do turn your videos on. If your video is off, I will not mark attendance. I have told you earlier also, if your video is off, I used to write there V. I don't mark present for you. Okay. Now the last method that we learned the previous day was heat and cold treatment. By keeping the food inside the refrigerator, we can preserve food. Food will not get spoiled that easily when it is inside the refrigerator. Why, Parvati? Why the food is not getting spoiled easily when you keep inside the fridge? What is special about a refrigerator or a fridge in terms of temperature?
It's temperature.
Temperature is?
It's cold.
Temperature is cold. Too low so that microbes cannot survive and the food can be preserved. And cold treatment or by making the products or by making these food items hot or by heating them. For example, we sterilize water by boiling it. And milk also can be sterilized by boiling it. We usually drink milk after boiling it. But certain milk packets, we can drink it as such without boiling. And in those packets, it will be written outside, pasteurized milk. What is pasteurized milk? What does it mean? Pasteurized milk means, have you heard about pasteurization? No.
Yes, eating at 70 degrees Celsius.
We learned it.
No.
Did we learn? Okay. So that is a method by means of which milk will be heated to 70 degrees Celsius for 15 to 30 seconds and then it will be suddenly chilled or cooled and it will be stored. And pasteurized milk you can consume, you can drink it without boiling, because by this method, by pasteurization, the germs will get killed. So let us learn. Let us learn more about heat and cold treatment.
Ma'am, can you show the last slide you took last day?
What is that? This one, no? Heat and cold treatment? Yes. Okay. Heat and cold treatment. You know that upon heating, upon boiling, microorganisms can be killed. They cannot survive at high temperature. Similarly, when the temperature is too low, when the temperature is too high or too low, microbes cannot survive. That is why we make use of heated cold treatment to sterilize the food items. Once again, boiling kills many microorganisms. Now we have water purifiers and all. Earlier, what we used to do is we used to boil the water before drinking. We should drink only sterilized or boiled water, and that too we have to bring the water to rolling boil for some time. Only then the germs will be killed. As soon as the bubble starts appearing, you should not turn the stove off. It has to come to rolling boil for a few minutes. Then the germs will get killed and the water will be safe for drinking. Similarly, keeping the food inside the refrigerator also can prevent the growth of microbes. That is why leftover food or vegetables and all we pickle as such also, if we keep outside also, it won't get spoiled easily because of the preservatives that we have added, like salt, vinegar, oil, etc. Anyhow, both heat and cold treatment can prevent the food from getting spoiled. Now, pasteurization of milk. Can anybody tell me why it got the name pasteurization?
Why this Louis Pasteur.
By Louis Pasteur.
Yes, this was found out by Louis Pasteur, and hence the technique or the method also got the name pasteurization. So you should know the temperature to which the milk is heated and how long. The milk will be heated about 70 degrees Celsius for 15 to 30 seconds, not minutes, seconds. And then it will be immediately cooled and then stored. So that will kill the germs and it will be safe to drink without, even without boiling. So here you can see in the milk packets it is written. Have you noticed it before? Pasteurized.
Yes,
ma'am. The milk. So pasteurized means already that has been treated well to kill the disease causing germs or microorganisms, discovered by Louis Pasteur. You can see his picture there, Louis Pasteur, and he found out a method for sterilizing milk. Is it clear? You should know, you should know the temperature as well as the time for which it is treated. 15 to 30 seconds, the milk will be heated at around 70 degrees Celsius and then it will be suddenly cooled and then stored. So with that, we have completed the heat and cold treatment for preserving food items. Now coming to the last method, storage. Yes. Yes.
Ma'am, fermentation also discovered by him.
Ah, yes, yes. Oh, you're remembering what we learned last class, means last chapter. Okay.
Ma'am, it is the same chapter.
Oh, okay, microorganisms, because it was in the first term that we learned, no? That's why. Okay. Storage and packing, that is the last method of preserving food. Dry fruits and even vegetables are sold in sealed and airtight packets. So when we store these products, whether it is dry fruits or vegetables, in airtight sealed packets, then that can be preserved from spoilage, because you know that the air contains these microorganisms, and once you make the packets so tight, airtight, so no microbes can enter from outside, and the food items kept inside will remain fresh. See here, you can see some dry fruit packets, even in cans also we store them, and different food items, not only nuts or dry fruits are available in cans. We even get meat, fish, tuna and all. You might have seen it in supermarkets and all. In cans, you get preserved food. And because of the airtight containers, it will not get easily spoiled. So that is the last method by means of which you can preserve the methods. Sorry, by means of which you can preserve the food. There are several more methods, but in your textbook, these are the six methods mentioned. We learned about chemical method, preservation by salt, preservation by sugar, preservation by oil and vinegar, heat and cold treatment, and finally, storage and packing. While it is being stored and packed also, we can take precautions so that it will not get spoiled easily. Is that okay? Can I proceed? Yes. Next, we are going to learn about a new topic, not related to what we learned so far. The chapter is about microorganisms. So you know that microorganisms, some of them, they can act as biofertilizers. And here we are going to learn about nitrogen cycle, where microorganisms play a very important role. Not just one group, several groups, nitrogen fixing bacteria, denitrifying bacteria, ammonifying bacteria, several bacteria are there which play an important role in nitrogen cycle. So that is why, yes.
Rhizobium bacteria.
That is rhizobium bacteria is an example for nitrogen fixing bacteria. Okay. And so here, this topic, this particular cycle is included under the chapter microorganisms because they play a very important role in nitrogen cycle. What is the percentage of nitrogen in the atmosphere? 28%. Very high percentage of nitrogen is present in the atmosphere. But can that be used by plants and animals?
No.
Then
they need to be in soluble form.
Yes, exactly. They need it in the soluble form, in the compound form. Only then they can absorb it, only in the soluble form from the soil. Plants will absorb it from the soil, and by feeding on plants, we too get a share of these nitrogen compounds. But atmospheric nitrogen, the 78% of nitrogen is in the form of gas, and the gaseous nitrogen cannot be utilized by our body, neither by our body or by that of the body of plants. So it has to be, nitrogen has to be converted to nitrogen compounds to be utilized by plants and animals. So for that, we need bacteria. You had learned about nitrogen fixing bacteria like rhizobium, blue-green algae, etc. What they do, children? They will convert
atmospheric nitrogen soluble form of nitrogen.
Very good. Into soluble forms of nitrogen and add it to the soil, and we call them as nitrogen fixing bacteria. And once they have fixed it in the soil, from there the plants can absorb it. Okay, so let's learn more about nitrogen cycle. Nitrogen, now I told you that plants and animals need it in the soluble form. Why is it so essential? Why can't we do away with it? Why we need it? Because this nitrogen is a very important component of proteins. Your nucleic acids, have you heard about DNA and all? No.
Yes.
Okay. Yes. So DNA, RNA, proteins, chlorophyll in plants, all these, even the different vitamins, they all contain nitrogen. So nitrogen is very, very important component. We cannot live without nitrogen. So that is why nitrogen cycle becomes very important. All living things need it for their survival. The nitrogen in the atmosphere is converted into nitrogen compounds. Who will convert? Nitrogen fixing bacteria like rhizobium bacteria and blue-green algae. Rhizobium bacteria, blue-green algae, etc. can convert atmospheric nitrogen into nitrogen compounds. Now, not only by nitrogen fixing bacteria, there is yet another method by means of which nitrogen can be converted into compounds. That is also a natural method. Industrially, on a commercial scale, in industries, we can convert nitrogen into nitrogen compounds. But here, we are learning about the natural methods. One method is by nitrogen fixing bacteria. Second method is by lightning. Once again, I will repeat. Atmospheric nitrogen will be converted to nitrogen compounds by nitrogen fixing bacteria. Children, actually, it will be first converted to then ammonia, then nitrate. So different types of bacteria are involved in this process. So you don't have to learn about the names of these different bacteria or the different stages involved. You just need to know that nitrogen present in the atmosphere will be converted to nitrogen compounds. Actually, it involves a few steps in between before it becomes nitrogen compounds or nitrates. All those details you don't have to learn, but understand that nitrogen present in the atmosphere will be converted to soluble compounds of nitrogen. And that is brought about by nitrogen fixing bacteria like rhizobium and blue-green algae. Apart from that, one more method is there. You call it as lightning. You have heard about lightning? You have experienced, you have seen it, no? And when lightning takes place, the temperature will increase. The temperature in the atmosphere becomes very high. And that will promote the formation of nitrogen compounds. The nitrogen, actually, nitrogen is existing as molecules, N2. They will split and form nitrogen atoms. This nitrogen atoms will combine with oxygen and form nitrogen compounds. So don't worry about all the details. Just understand that when lightning takes place, the temperature in the atmosphere will increases. That will also promote the formation of nitrogen or compounds of nitrogen. Is it clear?
So one temperature increases, right?
Yes, temperature will increase during lightning. The temperature will become very high, and that will help in the formation of, or that helps the nitrogen to combine with oxygen to form compounds of nitrogen. Once again, there are two methods by means of which nitrogen can be fixed in the soil. One is by means of nitrogen fixing bacteria, and the other one is by means of lightning. Okay, now what happens, children? The compounds have reached the soil. Now from the soil, who will absorb? Who will absorb?
Plants
will take it. And who will take it from plants?
Animals.
We all feed on plants either directly or indirectly. So we feed on plants. And what happens when they die again? When plants and animals die, yes. And what happens to those nitrogen compounds? It will again go back to the soil. Clear? From the soil, they will take it up. And from plants, animals, and when they die and decay, again it will come back to the soil. And not only after death, even the excreta of animals contain nitrogenous waste or nitrogen compounds. So that is also another method by means of which these nitrogen compounds are reaching in the soil. Is it clear? I'll repeat once again. From the soil, you learned how the compounds are reaching the soil. From the soil, plants will take it along with water. And when animals feed on plants, we get a share of it. And when plants and animals die, all these compounds will go back to the soil or through their excreta. And this like a cycle, you can see it is like a cycle. It keeps on getting repeated. And more nitrogen will come to the soil. Now children, let me ask you one question. I told you the percentage of nitrogen in the atmosphere is 78%. If you keep on, or if by lightning and nitrogen fixing bacteria, if it is added to the soil, will this amount be less? It will gradually decline or decrease, no?
No.
No.
Why? Why it is not declining?
Because it is still in the earth.
Because it is used by plants.
No, what I said is, wait a minute.
It is a cycle.
This is 78%. From here, lightning, nitrogen fixing bacteria, they're fixing it in the soil. So the 78% will get reduced, no?
They will become gaseous, back to gaseous form again.
Who will do it? That is my question.
Bacteria.
Bacteria.
See, there is yet another type of bacteria. Name is not mentioned. You call it as denitrifying bacteria. You call it as denitrifying bacteria. And what is their role? Some amount, not the whole thing, some amount of nitrogen compounds, they will convert to atmospheric nitrogen and release back to the atmosphere. What for? To maintain the 78% constant always. Clear? Once again,
I'll repeat
the points once again. Those who haven't understood, please listen. Once again, we'll just summarize the points. Atmospheric nitrogen will be converted into nitrogen compounds both by lightning and nitrogen fixing bacteria. And from the soil, plants will absorb it. And when animals feed on plants, they too get a share of it. When through their waste and their decomposition after death, this will reach back the soil. And again, plants will take it, and this keeps on getting repeated in a cyclic pattern. And in order to maintain the amount of nitrogen in the atmosphere constant, denitrifying bacteria will convert some amount of nitrogen back into gaseous nitrogen, and which will go back to the atmosphere. So the percentage will always be kept constant. Clear? Have you
can repeat that sentence of denitrifying bacteria?
Denitrifying bacteria will convert some amount of nitrogenous compounds back into nitrogen gas. So here is the point there. Certain bacteria, name is not mentioned. It is denitrifying bacteria. What is their role? What they do? They will convert nitrogen compounds back to nitrogen gas, not the entire nitrogen compounds, small amount, some amount, they will convert back to nitrogen, which will be released into the atmosphere so as to maintain the percentage of nitrogen in the atmosphere constant. Yes? Understood? Have you understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Can I stop sharing? Okay. I will just quickly summarize it once again. Now, once I have finished, then it is your turn. Agreed? So yes. I'm going to summarize it once again. The amount of nitrogen present in the atmosphere is
78%.
And why nitrogen is very important? Because it is an important constituent of nucleic acids, proteins, vitamins, then what else? Chlorophyll. So it is very, very important. And nitrogen present in the atmosphere is in the form of gas that cannot be utilized by plants and animals. So what happens then? Nitrogen fixing bacteria and lightning will help in converting atmospheric nitrogen into soluble compounds of nitrogen. And once this has reached the soil, plants will absorb. And when we feed on plants, we will also get a share. And when plants and animals die or through their excreta, this nitrogen compounds will again go back It will go back to the soil. Okay. And then again, plants will absorb. And again, these animals will get it from plants. And both plants and animals die. These nitrogen compounds go back to the soil. And that will get, this process will get repeated. And there is yet another group of bacteria, which you call as denitrifying bacteria. They will convert. What is their role, Carolyn? What is the role of denitrifying bacteria?
They will convert the nitrogen compounds into soluble form.
Compounds are soluble form. Denitrifying bacteria will convert some amount of nitrogen compounds in the soil back to, what is the other form?
Nitrogen gas.
Gas. It will convert it into gaseous nitrogen or nitrogen gas, which will go to the atmosphere. Why, Carolyn, it is important? Why it is important?
It is important to convert so that the plants can take the nitrogen.
No. Who can tell me why it is important? Why denitrifying bacteria should convert some amount back to gaseous form? Yes, Sriram.
I'm so that that nitrogen in the atmosphere can be constant.
Yes. Got it, Carolyn? Because I told you it is 78%. And if this atmospheric nitrogen keeps on getting converted to nitrogen compounds and reach the soil, what will happen to the 78%? It will go down. Am I right? Yes, Carolyn?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So we have to always keep the level constant. So some bacteria known as denitrifying bacteria will convert a portion of these nitrogen compounds back into nitrogen gas. What for? To maintain the percentage of nitrogen in the atmosphere constant. Always it will remain around 78%. Is it clear? Yes, Carolyn?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. And I have completed it, and I want you to summarize the main points. Who will start? Gauri can start. Nitrogen cycle. To begin with, what you'll say?
There is 78% of nitrogen in the atmosphere. Certain bacteria and lightning helps.
Not bacteria. Wait, Gauri. Bacterium is singular. Bacteria is plural. So bacteria you should not say. Okay, continue.
Okay, ma'am. Certain bacteria convert certain bacteria and lightning.
Which are those bacteria? You know about them.
Rhizobium bacteria convert the atmospheric nitrogen.
What do you call the group of bacteria? Nitrogen dash bacteria. Nitrogen. Nitrogen fixers. So nitrogen fixing bacteria. And what they do?
They convert the atmospheric nitrogen into nitrogen compounds. Which will later be absorbed by plants.
Okay, enough. Don't say the whole thing. I will give the chance to Amna. Now what happens? They have converted it into nitrogen compounds. It has reached the soil. Now what is next, Amna?
Plants absorb.
Now, Hessa, plants have absorbed it.
And then we use it.
We means only human beings?
No, animals.
Animals will absorb. What is next, Anusha? Plants absorb it, and from plants, animals get it. What is next now?
They turn left by nitrogen waste and excreta.
When plants and animals die, or through their excreta, it will reach back to the soil again. Then, Annette?
Yes, ma'am.
What is next? What is the role of denitrifying bacteria?
Denitrifying bacteria convert some nitrogen compounds in the soil into nitrogen gas.
Yes. Why? Why? Okay, Rudra can say why. Why denitrifying bacteria is doing so?
To maintain the percentage of nitrogen in the air.
Air, main term you did not say. To maintain
the
constant. Okay. Pranav, who was there near the window?
Then my mother.
You're talking to your mother through the window? You send her outside?
No, ma'am, she came to the
To check whether you're listening or not. Now, what Rudra was saying, tell me about denitrifying bacteria.
Denitrifying the nitrogen compounds into the atmosphere to maintain the nitrogen amount.
Nitrogen amount. Amount of what? What is there in the atmosphere? Nitrogen in which form?
Gas.
What is the percentage of nitrogen in the atmosphere?
78%.
Good. Okay. I'll take your attendance and we'll wind up. So thank you, children. We'll see you next class.
Thank you, ma'am.